Hello and welcome. Welcome to the live stream tonight. My name is Jesse and I work at Kitchener Public Library in Hefner Studio. I have with me Kitchener singer-songwriter Luke Michielsen. Welcome, Luke.
Hey. Hi, everyone. Thanks for joining us.
I'm wondering if you could tell us a little bit about like your songwriting process. So what does that look like for you? Does it always happen at a certain time of year in a certain way? Does the music come first? How does that happen for you?
What'll usually happen is, just in general, I have an open attitude towards songwriting. Like, I'm willing to accept a song or try out a song idea at any time. So I may not even be sitting down to write a song. I may just, like, for example, when I wrote my song Pine Needles, I happened to be just learning a cover because it was for my uncle's birthday party and he requested a Blue Rodeo song, Is It You? And so I was kind of learning that song and I spent a good hour and a half kind of learning how to sing it and learning how to play it. And then just suddenly after that, like, I think it was the key that we were playing in, it was like G chord shapes with a capo at the fifth fret. So it's key of C, the most pleasing key, arguably.
I agree.
And then I just started, like, you know, unexplainably just playing different licks in that position. And I was like, oh, this sounds good. And then a line just came out, like, coffee in the morning doesn't clear the frog in my throat. Because, like, I was actually just drinking coffee that morning and thinking, like, how my voice didn't sound as clear as I wanted to, as right. I wanted it to, and that the coffee wasn't helping it. And a lot of my themes kind of go around that, like, nothing is either black or white. There's good things about drinking coffee, but there's also detrimental things. And that's just kind of how life is. It's like this balance of you know, negatives and positives, or it's even more complex than that. It's not just negatives and positives. It's the nuances of life. So I really try to get nuances into my songs. So that's a great example of how I wasn't even trying to write a song, and I was just learning a cover, and then something happened to just come out, and then I got this feeling like, oh, that's good. Like, I could play that again and be happy with it. So one of my benchmarks for the songs that I write, I ask myself, is this a song that I'm likely to enjoy playing in a month from now? Am I going to be bored of it or think that it doesn't connect to me anymore? So I like to think about that. And if I start to think, no, I bet I'm going to love playing this song in a year or 10 years from now, then I kind of know that it's a keeper.
Yeah. Like, does it have that lasting effect?
And for me, there has to be a little bit of mystery in the lyrics, even to myself, because if it's so one-dimensional and I'm only, like, saying literal things in the lyrics, I'll probably get bored of it or I won't resonate with it in the future. I want it, like, the interpretation of it to change and morph through the years as I continue to, like, hold that song in my catalog and play it over and over again.
Yeah, well, and maybe even it will mean different things to you over the years, the same song.
Yes, yeah.
I like that a lot. And so I'm a singer-songwriter myself, and as you know, we know each other. And one thing that I find is that I'll get that one line, like you had your coffee in the morning line, and the whole song will just flow out of that. Was it that way for Pine Needles?
Exactly. Yeah. The whole song was written in no longer than an hour and a half. Like after that first line came out, I think I actually wrote that one down. Cause if I write a song really fast, I find that it helps to write it down. If I'm writing it over several weeks, often I'll just memorize it as I'm writing it. But anyway, that was a really quick one where it was definitely memorized like by the next day. And I remember like by the time I was into the outro part, I was actually like up out of my chair with a guitar strap, and I was like walking around the living room, like playing it and singing those, like just blasting into that outro part in that song. That outro actually got written because I was feeling so passionate about the song.
Yeah.
And it just like, I said, this song needs that. Like, it just feels like it comes to you from somewhere else. Oh, surround me. Oh, surround me. Oh, surround me.